Hi, and welcome to my review of Ghostbusters Afterlife. Yes, this fine film finally came out the other day, on Thursday. I saw it on Thursday, and then I went again on Friday. So I've seen it twice, so that's why I've waited a while to do my review. I've wanted to see it twice, just so I could get my final opinion on what I do think of the film. So this video is unscripted. I have no script, I have no clue what I'm talking about. So if I ramble on about some things, sorry about that, but I have no script, like some other videos, I plan out what I'm going to say and stuff, so. But yeah, I also have to say, if you haven't seen it, you need to see this film. It is my favourite Ghostbusters out of them all. I love Ghostbusters 1 and Ghostbusters 2, like, that's what we got into this whole franchise. Like, I've, like, you know, collected all my stuff, like, made my suit and all that stuff. But, oh my goodness, this film delivers on everything we have been waiting for. The past 30 years, like, it has the original guys in it. Also, I'm gonna say this is a spoiler for you, so if you don't want any spoilers, get off this video because I'm gonna talk about spoilers a lot. But yeah, it has the original guys in it, Ecto 1, the proton packs, the traps, PK me out, like, and there's like new upgrades and everything. It's just great. So, I'll give you a quick, if you haven't seen the film, or you have, I'll just give you a quick synopsis on what happens in the movie. So, it starts off with Egon. In his Shandor Mining Co. Truck, and he's like driving around like crazy away from something because he sees like kind of force, like an invisible ghost. There's like, I think it's a pterodon, the pterodon that comes after him. And then he's driving and he goes on some corners and he's about to get to his house, but then the pterodon like flashes into the side of his car and it flips over. So he runs to his house and he's basically later on in the film you find out under the floor. In his house, he wasn't actually doing farming at the farmhouse. He placed a bunch of traps there to basically his house was a giant ghost trap and stuff. And he tries to get it to work to catch a pterodon. He's holding a trap like that, but it doesn't work and the power all shuts off. So he runs in his house and he sits in a seat with his picking it waiting. He sees smoke come down like the sentinel pterodon that has been released comes up with smoke. And then you kill him, kills him like how Dana was captured in Ghostbusters 1 with the hands, the pterodon hands will cut the chain, just see him get grabbed like that, and then it cuts to Ghostbusters after. So that's the beginning. And then it goes to cuts to Trevor, Callie, and Phoebe in the house, and they get an eviction notice and stuff, so then they drive off to Egon's house to inherit all his like stuff, his death is left it to them. Callie's not too happy about it because Egon didn't really have anything to do with her, like he's not really, so she's kind of pissed off about that. Throughout the film, Janine comes in and says there's a lot of debt, but there's some stuff in there, you know, like, yeah, we wouldn't say left them anything and that, left you nothing. So, and it cuts to them going to Spinner's Diner and Trevor talking to Lucky. Trevor gets a job working there and all that stuff. And he, like, Phoebe's around the house and plays chess with the chessboard, falls off the thing randomly, she puts it back up, moves one chess piece, and basically it's Egon as a ghost because he's died, he's interacting with Phoebe and stuff. They play chess for a bit, you see more of Trevor working at his job and stuff, all that kind of stuff. And then Phoebe then realizes it's Egon, it's a ghost, and then like one of the chess pieces gets picked up and thrown, and then Egon guides Phoebe around the house to find the ghost trap, and then she takes the ghost trap to school, meets Podcast, they become friends, turns to Mr. Gruberson, and then Mr. Gruberson shows videos of the Ghostbusters and what they did back in the day, like the Manhattan cross rip and all that kind of stuff with Gozer and Marshmallow Man and Stay Puft. And then Podcast says, should we open it? And Mr. Gibson, the way his face is expressing, he's like, oh, we should open it. And they go out, they power it up with, I don't know, the charge from like the engine of the bus. And he tries to click the pedal, it doesn't work. And then he walks over, he's like, stay back. He taps it, and the Sentinel Terror Dog, another one, comes out the trap with the big horns. He flies into this cave, which I think he's shown it earlier in the film, I'm not sure, or like, I think it shows it after, which is a cave, basically. It looks like Gozer's door from the first one on top of the rooftop. It flies in there, you see all the cracks there, all like stuff, all that crazy jazz, and all that stuff. And then you see Trevor This might be wrong, it's just going off memory from the film. Trevor, the one part Trevor goes into the... Lucky brings him up to the mine with some friends, and they go there and sit there and talk about, Lucky asks, why are you here and where'd you come from? And Trevor says, we've been evicted, and all that stuff. And then underneath, like, you know, in the trailer, the thing starts rumbling. The mine shaft, and then they look down into it, and it's like a giant ghost, like, kind of thing. This is like Zool or Gozo or something, I can't remember what it says. It says Gozo or something, it's like forms a face and it comes up a bit and it shoots out of the mine stuff, and they kind of get scared a bit. And then, like, there's one part where, and I think it goes to Phoebe and Podcast go down into the where the mine was, and he's telling the story how the miners killed themselves in, like, sacrifice and stuff for Goza to worship her and stuff. So they go down there, he talks about it, and then you see them, and later on it goes to them first testing out the proton pack and stuff. And Phoebe, before that actually, Phoebe, like, gets led down into Egon's basement, which is a secret basement near his house, near somewhere, she uses the PK meter, and they find a... She finds the proton pack and all the stuff, the equipment, the suits, the outfits, everything. There's a cool little few Easter eggs down there for the fans if you want to, when you watch the film. I've noticed a few so far. And then Egon shows her what pieces to put on. She builds the proton pack, and then later on you see her test out the proton pack. She puts it on, and then Podcast puts the goggles on, and they test and fire some bowls and stuff, and it, like, just disintegrates them. And, like, Podcast is, like, overly excited about what happened and stuff like that. But then after they test it, they hear Muncho in, like, this kind of metal kind of piping area, and they're like, let's go check it out. Phoebe walks over with the wand in her hand, they go in it and stuff, and then see Muncho and then and stuff, and they're like, think about what's going on. So Podcast comes up with a plan to use the ghost whistle, which is seen earlier in the film, where he, like, takes it, was in Egon's house, and he asks Callie, can I have it, and he gets to keep it. And then he uses the ghost whistle, blows it, and it freaks Muncho out, and, like, no, he, like, looks at them, then he screams, and a bunch of the metal, like, pieces of, like, kind of like bullets, they fly out, and they duck down. And then when they come back up, Phoebe, like, fires at him, and, like, blasts or everything, and, like, they get Muncho. And then she's like, throw the trap, and then a freaking Podcast throws the trap out, but it's, like, falling over. They miss Muncho and all that stuff. And then you see Trevor fixing up the Ecto-1. He fixes the car with a bit of help from Egon. You see one of the wires Egon puts it in, and the engine starts, and he goes off down through the field, like, from the trailers, and he flies around and stuff and all that. So he meets up with them, and he pockets, like, can you give us a ride? Gives them a ride, and then they see Muncho from the trailer as well. Find out there's gonna see, they blast him. They miss him, and they blow up a bunch of, like, Spinner's Dino where Lucky works. And then they're like, oh, he's heading for the mine. And they go down this giant road, and they, like, blast him and, like, get him. And, like, they find, like, the RTV, and they put the RTV out and stuff. And that stuff happens, and they catch him and, like, blast him. Get rid of the trap, and the car does this awesome skid. They, like, scream, whoa, and then the car skids around the corner, and they park it and stuff. All that stuff, and then they, like, kind of do a shot, and they look up the mine as if something's happening. And then everyone, Lucky, gets involved, and they're like, oh, the only way we're going to find out what's going on is we go in the mine. So they all go in the mine. Either channel's there, right in the casket, and there's a bunch of proton packs set up on, like, little stands, and, like, then this whole place starts rumbling, and they talk about dates on the wall of when, like, Goz is coming back, like, to 84 and that. And then all the ghosts come up, and, like, Goz is trying to form, but then all the PK meter goes off, and, like, a trap, a proton pack goes off, and all four of them, and they all blast in the middle of it, kind of crossing the streams, but not, like, together, but, you know, they kind of, all the beams shoot down into the portal thing, and then all the ghosts go back down. And Alvar Shenlock kind of wakes up and freaks out Podcast when he goes, like, just, you know, goes up to sleep again, I guess, like, being resurrected, all that stuff. And then they get out of there. They talk more about what's going on with the ghosts and all this kind of crazy stuff, and then later on, Mr. Gruberson is in a shop, and all the mini puffs come out. He sees a pterodactyl, he runs away from it, like, crashes out of Walmart, and that possesses him. And then Callie finds out Egon's basement, and there's a bunch of pictures of her. As like throughout the years, basically Egon actually did care about her, and I followed her through her life and stuff. And she gets possessed by a terror dog and jumps out from the dark and gets her. All the kids come back to the house and like, mum, we found out all this stuff, but then she's possessed, and then jumps out the window and then finds Mr. Grimerson. They get together, and then once they're together, the whole goes as big temple thing, the eyes light up, and the terror dog kind of statue things, and all the everything just happens. Then all like the ghosts start flying out, and all that stuff. But then like ghosts are coming back, and like you see her come out of the portal, and that. And there's a part where like they get arrested, they get pulled over in the Ecto One by a policeman, which is Lucky's dad, and they get arrested, put in jail because of the damage they did. And Phoebe gets one phone call, phones up Ray, and then it explains like Egon. Freaking Ray's like, oh, I hate Egon. He took all the packs and all the traps. He took Ecto and like left them, made him go out of business because he was talking about the end of the world, and then none of them believed him, so they don't like anymore. But then she gets cut off, and Callie's mum comes in and like gets him out of jail. But she gets angry, and they have a bit of an argument. Then in the end, Gozer comes out the portal. Ivor Shandler's talking to her, and it's so funny. He's like, I did this all for you, and then Gozer just rips him in half. Like, just rips him in half. You just literally see him get split into two. Like, I love that part, it's so cool. And then Gozer's out, and all the ghosts come out, bug eyes in it from the cartoon, and like a miner that committed suicide in the films in it, all that stuff. And then they go there, pull up in the Ecto 1, they drive over there, pull up in Ecto 1. They have a plan where Phoebe tells some terrible jokes. One of my favourite ones is like, it's like a grasshopper comes up to a bar or something, and then the bartender's like, we have a drink named after you, and she's like, you have a drink named Steve? Oh, I just love that line. It's one of my favourite parts of the film. And then Gozer actually stands up, and her design is way cooler than the first one. She has like black eyes now and stuff. And then she's talking about like, have you come here to sacrifice yourself or something? And then she's like, what? And Phoebe's like, what? And then like Gozer goes, are you prepared to die? It's like a really cool different voice they did for her. And then she's like, no, I'm 12, are you? And then podcast gets the RTV, puts it under one of the terror dogs, and like sucks it in the trap. Callie's mum comes out the door, rolls on the steps, and then you see, oh, so cool. I wish I could show pictures and like that, but I can't because of I get taking the video down. And then what happens is you see Gozer go like that, and her like face goes away, and it pulls a part of her form off her, and they put it in the trap, put Callie's mum in the car, drive off, they have a bit of a conversation. He's like, I'm in, I'll help and stuff. And the terror dog like kind of chases the RTV. They do get it in the car in the end though. And they drive back to the farmhouse. And then they get back to the farmhouse. They're all waiting there. And the Ecto, the podcast, Trevor and the Ecto One. And then Lucky is also there. And then Lucky, Phoebe's out there with the ghost shop around. And then Gozer walks up to the farm. Lucky busts out the door and like says something, pulls the wand off and fires at Gozer, holding her still for a bit. And she's like, pull the lever, and Kazuma pulls the lever, and then all that stuff, and then they're blasting, and then they hit the pedal, and of course the power all goes off again. So what happens is Gozer grabs the beam and yanks Lucky on the floor, and then she gets the trap off Callie trying to pull it back, gets it open, and then the terror dog that comes out of it actually possesses Lucky, and Lucky turns into the terror dog and stuff, and Trevor's just got like a shocked face. He's like looking at her because he's in the gunner seat of the car, ready to blast and stuff because he came out. But then before, when they were firing, the reason and they had no power as well is Trevor's pack's getting pulled apart by a bunch of mini puffs, and he's like, Parker, what are you doing? Try and fix it. Yeah, so yeah, basically Trevor's like, fix it, and Lucky gets yanked on the floor, terror dog possesses her, it all goes to crap, and then she's about to use her electricity on Callie and Phoebe and all of them, really. But then you hear a very familiar voice, which is Dr. Venkman, Bill Murray. He's like, hey, Flat Top. And he's like, hey, have you missed us? And they're all sort of like, oh, it's them. And the guys, and even the meatballs in the back of the car, like, oh, they look at faces. Isn't that the final trailer? It's really, really cool. They start talking for a bit, and then Winter's like, I think she remembers us or something. And then Gozer is like, are you a god to Ray? And then do a funny joke where Ray's just standing there like, what is he just saying? He's like, Vic was like, oh, come on, Ray, or whatever. And then Ray's like, yes. And then they're like, we're all gods. He's like, let's fry this, whatever. And then they pull the wands off, they blast Gozer. Try crossing the streams, just like the first thing they think of. Crossing the streams, but then Gozer grabs the streams and uncrosses the streams. She holds all three of the beams and throws them back on the car. Then they're sitting there, about to get killed, because Gozer was going to kill them. She's like, the victims are, we're done for. Then you see Phoebe comes up with the proton pack, and she blasts Gozer, and she dodges it, so it goes past the neck like that. Phoebe blasts her, and then she turns around with electricity and does the thing with her hands, and they're kind of like, the beam and the electricity is kind of colliding, and they're like struggling, and Gozer's winning with her power, and like, Phoebe's getting pushed back, and the wand's like, kind of like that. And then one of the most heartwarming things in this whole movie, if you don't want to hear this, this is a spoiler, but really this is a whole video, it's basically a big spoiler for them, but Egon comes back as a ghost and holds the wand with Phoebe, and the music they do for the film is like, the score is so good as well. You see Egon holding the wand with her, and then all the music comes back on, big battle, Trevor's pack on the car, Ector gets fixed, and they, and all the guys stand up and they blast Gozer, and then they'll stop and Gozer. And then Trevor gets pack thing, but he doesn't actually blast Gozer, he blasts like the big power thing that powers the traps, he's like blasting that, and that gives it more power. They put the pedal and all the ghosts get sucked back in and stuff, and then the original guys say sorry to Egon for not believing him, that they should have called. Everything gets resolved, Lucky gets out the pterodactyl, same with Mr. Gruberson, gets taken out the dog, and they all turn into like the stone again, but they all rip it off like in the original film. And that's basically it, and then Egon has a moment with Phoebe and Trevor and hugs Callie like that, and he fades off. Then you see the original guys and their backpacks going off, like spinning, and there's a pan up shot to like the sky, and it says For Harold. And then, this is the very end of the film now, you see a shot of New York City, and the one going driving, and then the Ghostbusters song comes on, there's the song, and then you see the logo, like the original one, just come on and go, and there's the cross, and it zooms out to say, just Ghostbusters, and I thought just literally the original name of Ghostbusters, and plays the song, and the credits go, yeah, that's especially wand. That was very long, but okay, sorry if that's like kind of annoying, knowing about the, just telling the whole thing, but that was like, that's basically what happens in the film. All the guys come back, they stop Gozer, all that stuff, and the part with Egon is literally brilliantly done. The CGI is just absolutely amazing for the film. Like, Jason did this film to the best he could. I don't think they could have done it any better. I know a lot of the critics are saying this film is like kind of, no, it's just fan service, it's a land service, it's boring, there's nothing to it, it's all old, nothing new added to the film, but the film is like, I don't know, I don't even know what to say about it, it's just, it's one of my favourite films. I think it's better than Ghostbusters 1 and 2 in my opinion, but a lot of people disagree with that, but I of course love Ghostbusters 1 and 2, like, that's what my whole channel's about, Ghostbusters 1 and 2, like, all the clips and all that stuff. Yeah, it's just one of the greatest films ever. I've already seen it twice, as I said at the beginning. I plan on going a third time next week, or weekend. Cinema, or whatever the hell it's called in the UK, I can't remember. Some like cinema place that we got free tickets for. And, yeah, I don't know how much to say about my review. I just told you the whole film, and I'm like, I don't know. The film's just so good to me. I think it's absolutely brilliant. The only bad thing, I think, is like the relationship of like Trevor and Lucky wasn't really fleshed out too much. They could have done more with the characters, but bar that, like, the action is brilliant, story's great, characters, Phoebe and Podcast are the best, and they make this film, this whole movie. Their chemistry together is absolutely brilliant. I cannot wait for them to do another Ghostbusters. I really hope this one does good enough to go get another movie, because this film is just top tier level. Like, most like sequels to films aren't very up there, very good. But this film, like, Jason knew what he was doing. He knew what the fans wanted. He knew, like, oh, we're 2016, like, God, we can't just Like, this isn't better than that, because that film's just like... What the hell was that?
That film, I don't know how many words for that film.
But this film is just brilliant. If you haven't already seen it, go see it. It's literally so good. It's got 96% on Rotten Tomatoes from the audience. Like, right now, it's 95 yesterday, it's 96, everyone loves this film. But critics, it's only on a 62. And then most of them are just saying it's full of crap and it's just fan service and there's nothing, they don't really add anything new to it. And that 2016 was better and added something new to the franchise and like tried something different. But yeah, there's the film's not all CGI, so if you don't like all CGI and you don't want them how it did it originally. Most of the terror dogs are practical, some of the ghosts are apparently. But yeah, there's loads of practical effects done for the movie, which is just great. I just love that. I thought just Slimer's not in it, which I was really hoping he'd chop at least one part, but Slimer's not in it. There is a mid-credit scene with Venkman and Dana talking about the... doing the card thing from the first film, which shocked Venkman, because he like kind of listed the cards on the back to know what was going on. That's pretty fun. Funny scene. Then the end scene is like Winston talking to Janine about how, even though he's a big businessman, he's... he said he would always be a Ghostbuster, and then you see a shot of him go into the old firehouse. He buys it because he's got a massive business. You see actor one pulling, and he's like, "Oh, I'll fix you up and that." And then the best part, it pans to the old containment unit still there, and you see the light, the red one, start flashing with a bit of the sound of the containment unit powering up, and it cuts to black. So basically, that's kind of signal. Oh, yeah, they want to do another one if this one goes good. Something about the containment unit could happen, everything could go wrong again with the unit, which would be pretty cool to see. Like, maybe Slime would be in it in the next one, so maybe containing it and see all the old ghosts come out, maybe like the subway one and some of the other iconic ones and that were in the film, and maybe even ghosts we didn't see and stuff. Yeah, that'd be great. I hope this one does good, because I'd love to see, like Jason in his video review said, he'd love to see I would love to see a cartoon series like the real Ghostbusters, or just a cartoon series on TV or Netflix or something. Like, a Ghostbusters TV series would be great, animated. I'd have like the Phoebe characters, the new cast from Afterlife, all be in it. Awesome. They continue on, or it could be like, I don't know, they could do some of it. And there could be a continuation of Afterlife, but more ghosts start showing up, and then they get the firehouse, and all that kind of great, cool stuff. But even a live action one. Netflix, that'd be a great series. I'd love to see that. Might be able to get the whole cast back. I'm sure they'd be able to get McKenna Grace and like Trevor and Finn Wolfhard and like Logan Kidd. I'm sure they'd be able to come back and do something with it, because he's in like Stranger Things and you know, all that kind of stuff. But yeah, I'm sure they'd be able to do something. They must be able to do something with the franchise now. This film is good. But anyway, that's basically my little kind of short review and the synopsis of what happens in the film. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already seen Ghostbusters Afterlife, please go and see it. I hope you really enjoy this film, because I absolutely love this film to bits. I cannot wait for it to come out on digital and like the Blu-ray and stuff, because I'll probably buy like, all the versions, to be honest. I'll probably buy the DVD, the Blu-ray, play that 4K, I don't know, whenever it comes out. But yeah, really hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.